I am Wes Craven, and you're watching the Sci-Fi Channel.
Please hold for an important announcement.
Thank you.
Yeah, whatever.
Mike, it all started in a place called home. But sadly, it's ending today. Mike, I've recommended to the board that you be declared incompetent and therefore unsafe at any speed to lead as captain.
What? What's going on?
Exactly.
He just crossed his own T, didn't he?
I'm so sorry.
Well, I'll punch out. Hey, who's the new captain?
It's Gypsy!
I can't be captain. I have to run the ship.
Fine, bro.
Oh, I can. I just put a load of creepy crawlers in the thing maker. Mm. Well, Tom, how about you?
Yeah, I anticipated this and have prepared a statement. Gentlemen, and Gypsy, and Crow, and Mike, and Servo. I cannot be captain, for you see, dear friends, I am unfit to lead other men into battle, into space, or in a line dance. I submit that if I pick my nose for a half an hour, my head would cave in. I'm nary to know the distinction betwixt Shinola and that other stuff. I cannot lead because I cannot find my ass with both hands and a flashlight.
Well, Gyps, it looks like I'm staying then.
I've missed you.
I will now open the floor to questions about my incompetence.
Oh, I Mr. Servo.
Mr. Servo. Mr. Nelson.
Protein robot, village boy.
Mystery Science Theater 3000 is brought to you by Volcano. On Friday, the coast is toast.
That lake was 62 degrees yesterday. Today it's up to 68.
That's a sunny day.
It takes a geological event to heat a million gallons of water in 12 hours.
What is a geological event?
Please do not leave your home.
It's just exploded.
Please stay calm.
Volcano, rated PG-13. Friday, only in theaters. Imagine a place that surrounds you with elegance and pampers you with luxury.
Williams, the car, please.
Introducing the Infiniti QX4. It has all the comfort and style you'd expect in an Infiniti.
Williams, while we're young.
It's just a bit more assertive. The new QX4.
In 5 minutes, Eva.
Okay. You ready? You look great.
Couldn't do it without you, Lee.
Especially after...
That's what I'm here for, huh? A few weeks ago, I was getting Eva ready for her close-up when I noticed something. Dandruff. So I told her about Head & Shoulders. Regular shampoos just rinse flakes away so they can come back. Head & Shoulders helps prevent flakes from even forming. You see the difference?
White, please.
Mark?
You look beautiful.
Head & Shoulders, because great hair can't have flakes.
Delta protects this faucet with the same process that protects the space shuttle. Introducing new brilliance. Finally, a polished brass finish that's guaranteed to shine for life. From Delta, the faucet.
Mama said there'll be days like this, there'll be days like this. Mama said,
Mama said, Mama said,
Mama said there'll be days.
When your stomach
like this,
feels bad, reach for Pepto-Bismol. It's all your stomach needs.
Warning, the following offer is for mature audiences only. Exciting, mysterious, intense, graphic, provocative, raw. This is no ordinary animation. This is the exotic, bizarre, and beautiful world of Japanese anime. And this is your invitation to enter with the modern classic, Akira. Critics say Akira makes Blade Runner look like Disney World. It's action-packed, the future of animation. Siskel and Ebert call it the video pick of the week. Akira is yours for only $4.95 with subscription when you order the Best of Japanese Animation Collection Series. With these state-of-the-art sci-fi classics, you will enter a world beyond imagination, a future out of control, and an experience you will never forget. Don't say we didn't warn you.
Call 1-800-414-1136 now to order Akira for only $4.95 plus $3.59 shipping and handling with subscription. Future volumes are $19.95. All major credit cards accepted. Mature audiences only.
I am the Sci-Fi Channel. Saturday, I will project your cinematic dreams in the dimension of movie magic.
At 7, the Saturday double feature begins with an experiment out of control. Severed ties. And at 9,
nature's unstoppable.
The Sci-Fi Channel original movie.
Oh my God.
Habitat.
The Sci-Fi Channel weekends of wonder.
Tonight,
come with me.
You look pretty smug, Nelson, now that you got your command back. Your precious little command, Mr. Itty-Bitty Captain Pants.
Oh, Servo, you didn't want command.
Yeah, sure. Well, know this, Captain James T. Jerk. Your job is hanging by a thread. You're between Scylla and Charybdis, with the sword of Damocles hanging over you by a Gordian knot. Oh, someone's calling.
Hello?
Hey, Nelson Rockaloozer, what it is, what it was, what it shall be. We found Nimrod here.
Howdy!
And since this planet is so nice, I thought I'd teach these tenderfoots how to camp, maybe even do some hunting for grizzly bear, elk, or the three-horned Rastodian of Thinos 4. So while we're gone, you're on your own. I'm switching you to ship's batteries.
But we'll have no engines, and we'll be without shields in uncharted territory.
Oh! That's true. I didn't think of that. You know what else?
You'll be without diapers, too. Deal with it, you big, huge, giant babies. Okay, Brain Guy, Bobo, time to go camping. Bobo, you grab the camp stove. Brain Guy, why don't you take my cotton swabs? Thanks. Bobo, don't forget my water bed. Don't bother to drain it. Brain Guy, why don't you take the ping pong ball? Bobo, we'll need my 78s and the Victrola.
Okay.
Brain Guy, let's have you take my lipstick, the Knockout Red. Bobo, don't forget my vintage bass amp. And Brain Guy, I'm going to have you carry my false eyelashes. Thanks. Bobo, don't forget my collection of World War II helmets.
Okay.
Do you think we'll do any metal lathing?
Better safe than sorry.
Yeah, Bobo, bring the metal lathe and the bar stock.
Got it.
Okay, we're off. Now, who's going to carry me?
Well, I have my brain.
True. Eeny, meeny, miny, Bobo. For change of pace, Nellstone, I'm going to send you a movie. It's called I Was a Teenage Werewolf. Now, there's food in the synthesizer and no friends on the satellite. Bye-bye.
Oh, great.
Switching to auxiliary power. Shields are non-functional.
Oh, super. Adrift in a strange quadrant with no shields. Creatures of any sort could just wander in here and snack in our torsos, bury us till we're tender and come back for more.
Yikes.
Well, your torso, Nelson. No creature would want to eat us.
Quiet. What's that?
Sorry, little Charlie horse there.
No.
Sorry.
Be quiet, please.
Sounds like a can opener.
Warning, hull breach.
See, probably that can opener.
For crying out loud, I'll go see what it is. Bunch of babies can do everything myself. Okay, there. Whoa.
What do you take with the fingers? Oh, great. Okay, Mike. I gotta show you something, okay? And you see if you notice it. Well, just look at me as if I was normal, all right? I'll see if you can see anything. Oh, thanks a lot. Makes me feel real good, like I'm not sensitive enough about it already.
Okay, let's try to get this thing off of you.
I gotta catch up. Don't do that, Mike.
Seems pretty attached. Better let it just leech off my life force, lay its eggs in me. Won't be the first time. And then just let it go off on its own.
Well, I mean, does it hurt much?
Well, not a whole lot. Actually, it's kind of warm.
Oh, nice.
This is great. We've got an alien life form attaching itself to our crew.
Uh-huh.
We've got moving sights.
So it's really noticeable, isn't it? I was afraid about that.
As long as you're okay with it.
Of London.
You are not drinking a pina colada at Trader Vic's, young man. You're just not old enough.
Wow. We got a film and it's starring Michael Landon.
I was a teenage werewolf until that summer of passion when I became a man.
Werewolf has a lot of friends. He gets along well with his were peers.
Now, do his were mom and were dad know his whereabouts?
Filmed on Joan Collins' bed sheets.
Faye, make sure his hair is perfect.
Teenage werewolf! So, a wolf with zits, that's what we're getting here.
It's tough to work the Oxy-10 in past the fur.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I'm getting satin vertigo.
You know, one advantage of a werewolf, they scoop their own poop.
Isn't one Gene Fowler enough? Couldn't they have stopped?
10 days since last teen pregnancy.
Free pimple cream samples, yay!
Ebonics is a legitimate language.
We are not getting rid of goosebumps in the library.
No mas.
And the 35-year-old high school students look on.
Please, you're my guidance counselor.
Get the hell beat out of you, please.
You got enough? How do you spell it?
IT, I think.
New sports, sophomore tossing.
Tony. Ooh, right in the little Joe.
Oh, shouldn't be fighting his own dad.
I'm going to cultivate you to a uniform 2-inch step.
This is not part of the highway to heaven.
Disturbing racial undertones here.
This is for your bedwetting movie.
Not the peep, boss.
Wow, he fights dirty.
You get a lot of dirt with werewolves. You get a lot of clean with Tide.
Class president 1-2, photo club 2, werewolf 3 and 4.
You just had a crisis at the rendering plant.
Richard Jewell started it.
We'll have to draw your diagram.
Tony, I know you can get fresh.
With Summer's Eve.
A low cop-civilian ratio in this town.
Come on over here.
Okay, a little old lady got mutilated late last night. You kids know anything about it?
Come on, I want you to apologize to your son.
It's a Catholic high school. That's holy water.
I'll just get these crusty boogers off of this.
Wait for me in the car, Joe.
Crack a window so you don't die.
All right, Jimmy. Go ahead, you tell me.
Well, Sergeant Donovan.
I was reading Modern Maturity.
I'd like to blow a whistle on a pal.
A pal yet.
Well, you started it.
Look, you started it. You slapped me on the shoulder.
It's a friendly tap. I don't know what you got so excited
about. I don't like that kind of friendship. Wow. I don't like to be hit from behind by anybody anytime. I don't like to be touched.
Okay. The way you jumped me, you think I tossed a brick at you. Right off, he challenges me. I tried to kibitz him out of it.
I'm beginning to get the picture.
Yeah, and I even told him I was sorry. That's right. I apologized. You can ask any of the guys.
No,
he wanted to fight. I know I'm bigger than he is.
But he wanted to fight.
Look, what are you, the referee or in his corner?
No, Tony, I'm really in your corner. If I can just get you to see it.
I'm sorry, we'll go pick up Richard Jewell.
Well, I guess you can pick up your marbles. I'll try to low-key this in the report, but what your principal wants to do, well, that's her business. Now, wait a minute.
My kiss?
Before you go, I want to see you two fellas shake hands.
And come out fighting.
No, wait.
Come on. It'll look better in the report.
Sure, a happy ending, huh?
Come on, shake. Give me your paw. There.
I'm sorry, Tony. I guess I lost my head. I burn easy.
Now, I got to get back to the bank. Got some loan applications to go over.
Oh, Tony, you really ought to smile more often.
Sure. Win friends and charm snakes, huh?
That's just what I wanted to talk to you about.
Snakes.
Suspicious of everybody. Act like the whole world's your enemy the way you flare up.
Oh, people bug me.
That's right. Hide behind jive talk. People bug you. Well, people bug me, too. But I don't go around clouding everybody.
Come on.
Finish your beep, will you?
All I know is you've been in trouble a half a dozen times.
That's
you don't have any official record yet, but you're sure working up to one.
Head on.
But you got a crystal ball, huh?
I pulled you out of fight three times myself in the last month. You're just lucky there weren't any formal complaints. The time before this in the supermarket.
It was the checker's mistake.
Yeah, but you didn't even give him a chance to rectify it. Boom, you throw a carton of milk right at him.
It contained bovine growth hormone and he turned into a giant cow.
Tony.
I threw milk once too.
I'm just trying to tell you that you need help.
The Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints.
What kind of help?
Well, there's a prominent doctor. Dr. Brandon. He's a consulting psychologist out at the aircraft plant. He's been working with the police department without charge, trying to help difficult kids adjust.
He's working with Richard Jewell right now.
It's a just kick.
Polish off the rough edges. Adjust.
Adjust to what?
Everything. Teachers, parents, other students.
Pants, coffee.
You know, some kids have a tougher time than others, and it's not necessarily their fault. Now, this Dr. Brandon, well, he's modern. He uses hypnosis.
He's hep and he's mod.
Oh, no. No head shrinker for me, thanks.
A hair shrinker, maybe.
You know, that's all I need. That's all I need. Tony the Flip. No, sir, thank you. You keep the man in the white coat for the goofs. I can take care of myself.
The way you have up to now?
That's one for meat face.
The way I have.
Can I stay at your place?
Then you won't let anybody help you.
Not into a straitjacket, I won't.
They're in your color.
Look, you hold me on any charge?
Second degree milk hurling.
No.
Then I can go.
Yeah, you can go.
I gotta go throw ricotta at a stock boy.
This is the last warning, Tony. If you get into trouble again...
It'll be the chair for you.
Don't expect it to be a breeze like this. I can't let you off.
Okay. I heard you.
Officer Thick Face.
Hey, don't you do that. You put that butt right back in your pants, young man.
Yeah, I better go work on the Black Dahlia case.
Edgar Winter's little sister.
Everything all right, Tony?
Sure it is.
What did Officer Donovan say?
I don't want to talk about it. I've had enough yakety-yak to last me till the end of the term.
And she likes him because...
Where am I going?
Look, I'm sorry, Arlene.
I hit you with that Gouda.
I say things, I do things, I don't know why.
Because you're a jerk.
I try to control him, it's too late. I've gone too far.
I smeared Dad with mascarpone last night.
I don't know, I get a certain feeling and I have to...
Throw dairy products.
I don't know. I just don't know.
Let me know for you, Tony.
You must try.
Yeah, I'll try. But not Donovan's way.
What's his way?
He wants me to go to this head shrinker, Dr. Brandon. Like I was a flip or something.
Is that the way he said it?
No, he sprinkled a little sugar on it. But I'm not having any, thank you.
Let's go milk his house.
Okay, I'll try. But my way.
The way she tarts around in that outfit.
Come on, I'll take you home.
I can lash out at you more freely there.
John Carradine has major booty compared to Michael Landon.
My paw is caught in the accelerator.
If I were a bug, I'd be proud to smash into that grill.
Yep.
Ooh, your nose is cold.
She lives on the corner of enable and codependent.
A storm rolling in, and Mom's not due for another hour.
Hey! What about me?
A pretty tight spot, unless you have MCI. The kids dial one special number, and that one call goes to Mom's office, then to her cell phone, then right to her.
Get in, I'm so glad you called.
And Mom rolls in right before the storm.
Let me in the phone booth, Mom.
There's no room, dweeb.
Dork.
Dweeb.
Dork.
If you wear ordinary contact lenses, your eyes may not be as comfortable as they could be. Irritating dirt and deposits build up.
Tell me about the free contacts.
I was just getting there. But AccuView always gives you the comfort of fresh new lenses.
The free contacts?
Oh, right. Call Johnson & Johnson at 1-800-701-6100 and get a free trial pair of AccuView from your doctor. The contacts doctors prescribe most.
Free is good.
Your eyes will feel better all day long.
I like free.
You should call, too. 1-800-701-6100.
U.S. gold medalist Mia Hamm spends 90 minutes destroying her hair and 90 seconds bringing it back with Pert Plus. More than a shampoo, it conditions too. How? As you shampoo, the conditioners stay suspended. As you rinse, the conditioners go to work, giving you great hair simply. Perfect for Mia, because she wants great hair, but she'd rather be living in it than working on it. Wouldn't you? Pert Plus. Simply great hair. Simply.
From Sony's PlayStation come the greatest hits, all your old favorites.
Like the soft sounds of swarming missiles.
And the gentle crack of Sophia's whip.
You know, the hilarious antics of Sweet Tooth, that lovable clown.
All for just $24.99 each, but wait.
There's more?
Oh. That's right, the PlayStation is a mere $149. And you can also get leading titles.
Like Crash Bandicoot and Jet Moto.
For just $49.99 and less.
You are not ready.
After launching an intergalactic deep space probe, we have finally found the heart of science fiction. Sci-Fi Entertainment Magazine. Your veins will vibrate all year long with a year's subscription. 9 intriguing issues, all for less than the price of a monster's meal. Just $19.95 for a full year by calling 1-800-77-SCI-FI. Yes, it is shockingly low. Call 1-800-77-SCI-FI to subscribe. Once you do, you'll never miss a beat.
She's a lady. Oh, 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 she's a lady.
AM Gold. All of your favorite hits of the 60s and 70s in one fantastic collection.
The say, Brandy. You're a fine girl.
You're a fine girl.
What a good wife you would be.
Get AM Gold for just $9.99 on compact disc or double length cassette. That's 22 fabulous hits.
Sweet, sweet city woman. Just an old-fashioned love song.
Cherokee people, Cherokee tribe. Side, side.
Then audition other great AM Gold albums. There's no minimum to buy. Cancel anytime.
I think I love you, so what am I so?
Call now. To order AM Gold 1971, call 1-800-681-0909. Call now or send $9.99 plus $3.50 shipping and handling to the address on your screen.
Can't go back there.
Hey, it's depressing, Dad.
I haven't killed myself yet, son.
Hi, Dad. Hi.
Mom's still dead.
Who was it today?
What's the difference?
Your principal called. Said it was your fault.
Why does she bother you?
Because I'm your father. She said I'm supposed to discipline you.
Bad werewolf.
I told her at home you never needed discipline. Not even when your mother was alive.
I don't know why she has to drag you into it.
Go to your mat, son.
But boy, you missed the point.
Well, if you know, tell me.
Son, your blow comb is grounded.
Sometimes you just have to do things the way people want them done. That makes them happy and they leave you alone.
That's inspiring.
I used to have a foreman like that. Every time I assembled a motor my way, he beefed.
Ew.
But when I assembled it,
Dad, I don't like to be pushed around.
Wow.
Tony, sometimes you just have to do it the other fellow's way.
Why, sometimes he lit his beefs. He'd sit on my head and beef.
I gotta be going. Sorry I can't eat with you. Night shift again.
I don't want to, but a guy told me to.
Oh, there are a couple of lamb chops in the icebox. I season them the way you like. Just set them in the pan.
That'll make you beef.
Dad, I can cook a chop.
And be sure you cook them. Don't eat them raw like you did the hamburger yesterday.
That's all the foreshadowing we can afford now.
Tony.
Give up.
Think over what I said, would you? I mean about not being so stubborn.
Give in to despair.
This might make things a lot easier all around.
Take the droppings life offers.
Okay, Dad.
Off to my job at Dismal Co.
Brought to you by the Despair Council.
Ooh, he beefed before he left.
lamb chops. I wanted lime grilled brook trout.
Uh-oh. Milk.
Yep. He's gonna do it. He checks the runner. Spins and twirls.
What am I gonna put on my Cocoa Puffs?
Can I borrow some milk?
I gotta go. Bye.
My very abusive boyfriend is here.
Dad, played by H.L. Mencken.
Jabba the husband.
It's Tony, and he's not even late. Maybe you're beginning to train him.
That's no way to call for a date. When I courted your mother,
things were different then.
Mm-hmm. I still want my daughter treated with respect.
Your father's right, Arlene. Oh, Dad, it's got nothing to do with respect. That's the way all the kids do it.
But I still can't understand why you only date him. Oh, not that I have anything specific against Tony. But there's Steve Harmon, the druggist's son, and there's Willie Blake.
Oh, love, Mother. I date Tony because I like him. In fact, I like him a lot.
Why?
You just ask him to come in, Arlene.
Go ahead. We won't bite him.
What's he playing, Vulcan Solitaire?
All right.
Well, he may urinate submissively, I should warn you.
Tony, would you come in for a minute?
Come on, Tony. Come here, boy.
Yep.
Please don't sniff Dad's crotch, okay?
Good evening.
Mimi, Ike.
Hi.
Nyla Bone's son.
Tony.
Lick me.
I like things formal once in a while.
So put on a tux.
We just wanted to look at you before you take our daughter out to a party.
You'll understand the strip search.
You don't have any objections.
No, I don't.
Well, then why don't you call for her properly in her home?
Now, Dad.
No. A little man-to-man talk won't hurt anybody.
Careful. He's packing half and half.
Well, I would, only you don't look too pleased. No, really, sometimes when I walk in that door, I think you're going to swat me with a baseball bat or something.
Oh, I'm sure that's just your imagination.
It must be.
Mother, get the bat.
Unless you feel guilty about something.
Now, Dad, you promised.
It's the same. Parents of a young girl, and especially a pretty one like Arlene, like to feel proud of the young man that takes her out.
Another insurer, Mother?
A young man who keeps busy with the right kind of things.
Like sprinkle a lawn, take out a paper route, haul boxes in the market.
Where's the opener, Mary?
On the sink, dear.
Where's the sink?
Any job that keeps a teenager out of mischief and builds a good reputation.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, like our bank cashier. You know the one that's missing? The guy that ran off and lost it all at the track.
Now, being a smart aleck won't do it. You've got a bow to authority.
Everybody's on my back today.
Oh, Daddy, it's Halloween, and we have to go.
Yes, we don't want them to miss any fun.
Okay, I've said my piece.
Mom got her hair styled like Aaron Burr.
On one thing you can be sure of, Mr. Logan.
What?
At least I'll protect your daughter.
From creeps like me.
All right, kids, have a good time. Remember now, I want you home by 12. No excuses now. 12.
Noon tomorrow.
You heard what Dad said. Not after midnight.
Remember what your mother said about what I said.
Should have picked you up before 11:45.
Your parents are great. They're really fun.
Full moon. I wonder what that means. Probably nothing.
Hey, what got into your dad?
Despair. Beer.
You heard about the fight.
So it's over.
But I heard more.
I heard you cried.
More?
Tony, don't flare up. And please let me say it through once.
I hate you.
I asked about this Dr. Brandon.
He hates you, too.
Now, if he could really help you, it would be wonderful for both of us. And it would make things easier both at school and here at home.
Your will would be broken, and that'd be good.
Forget about the 4 years of waiting, college and all.
And your prison term.
Please, Tony.
Or I'll withhold cuddling.
Arlene, get this straight and get it final.
Ooh.
I'm not going to any doctor like Dr. Brandon.
Not even if you have to?
But I don't have to.
I love you, Tony, don't I?
Now, come on. Forget it.
I feel good about our relationship, don't I?
Mom's inside licking Metamucil off Dad.
Ooh.
It's the werewolf dance.
We're gonna tear out a deer's entrails.
Yeah.
I love you, Recessa Annie.
Bruno Hopman and Julie Nixon cut up on the dance floor.
Hi, I brought my jerk boyfriend, Tony.
Guitarist Mel Bay rocks the house.
They're listening to Kind of White.
She's dressed to dance the Shapoopy.
You can smell reefer, tide, and mildew down there.
Yeah,
Ginsburg, Corso, good to see ya.
Frank, how are you?
Hey, what do you say, Tony?
Hi, Arlene.
Hey, Tony.
Hi.
Tony, hear this.
One and...
Hey, man, you really got those things trained.
I slapped them silly, boy.
We got beat.
Vic, if you're going to play the bongos all night, who am I going to dance with?
Latch on to Frank. He's got no date.
But I came with you.
She's baby schnooks.
Look, how square can you get? You came with me, so you dance with him.
It doesn't make sense.
Ah, kids those days.
I'll clarify it for you. Hey, Frank.
Lighting fires and masturbating.
You want me?
Be my guest.
You know, my dog told me something fascinating today. The blood of my victims cleanses
really?
The earth.
Me?
Yeah.
Donna Reed and Ben Hogan.
Boy, this sure beats you, Center.
Supervised entertainment, 8 to 10.
Square dances and waltzes, and a cigarette is a crime.
Oh.
Scooby-Doo.
Mike, I'm going to ask you to kill me now. Mike, please kill me.
Well.
Ah, this probably hits home, eh, Mike?
Now,
well, what'd I do?
What'd I do?
What'd I do?
What'd I do? Okay, Servo, your turn.
Ah, you know, Mike, at first I thought this face hugger was annoying, but now it's really growing on me. Oh, but I kid this face hugger of mine.
Okay, Servo, your turn.
Okay.
Hey, hey, good news, everyone. My proximity detector just arrived from Daymark. Now we'll be able to get a handle on the foreign life force that's invading the SOL.
Proximity detector?
Yep. Detects infinitesimal variations in air density, so we'll know exactly how many of those little buggers are crawling around the ship.
Good.
All for 10 monthly payments of $19.99.
Good.
So I put it on my Discover card.
Good.
I didn't know Daymark took Discover. The Lillian Vernon doesn't. Finger hutch. No way. So the gal said to put it on my Discover. Yeah. Anyway, you were saying, Mike?
A proximity detector?
You what? Yeah.
All right, let's fire this baby up and find out where those little sons of are.
Okay. Let's go.
Oh, jeez. They're
what?
Everywhere.
What?
They're
what?
Under the floor.
No. What?
They're in the walls.
Oh, jeez. Oh, no.
Oh, God.
Okay, we gotta do something. Notify Gypsy to neutralize all functions unless absolutely necessary.
Absolutely necessary for human life support. I got it, Mike.
It's too late.
What?
Too late.
What do you mean it's too late?
Too late.
10 yards.
What? Hold me.
5 yards. They're coming right at us, Mike. He's on top of where? Okay, please, it's crawling with me.
We gotta get to the southwest corner of the basement now. Let's move.
Oh, for would you look at this? I had it on the wrong setting. I was measuring the humidity. Well, it sure doesn't make much sense to have the evil alien setting right next to the humidity setting.
Oh, boy.
I mean, I can't be the first person that's happened to.
Thanks for helping us out, Crow.
Yeah. Oh, don't mention it, Mike.
We'll be right back.
Oh, by the way, Mike, we have humidity on the ship. You might want to have that looked at. Okay?
Let me get out of my service.
Imagine a place that surrounds you with elegance and pampers you with luxury.
Williams, the car, please.
Introducing the Infiniti QX4. It has all the comfort and style you'd expect in an Infiniti.
Williams, while we're young.
It's just a bit more assertive. The new QX4.
To get him up and out the door. A class full of kids he's getting up for. I'll start Folgers to brew. The aroma will pull him through.
Folgers, made from mountain-grown beans, with an A-plus aroma to start your morning right.
Got a face each day brand new. 'Cause a teacher's got so much to do. So the best part of waking up is Folgers in your cup.
Can you believe those Potter fields?
What do you mean?
What? They went to Disney World.
Again?
Yeah, for that 25th anniversary.
When are they going to realize they're not kids anymore?
I don't know what's gotten into them.
Still whooping it up like a couple of teenagers, running around like they don't have a care in the world. It's ridiculous. What if we all acted that way?
Come celebrate Disney World's 25th anniversary. Call 1-407-W-DISNEY.
Say Mickey.
And remember the magic.
Mike Piazza spends 9 innings destroying his hair and 90 seconds bringing it back with a shampoo that conditions too, Pert Plus. Because Mike wants great hair with plenty of time for other things. Don't you? Pert Plus. Simply great hair. Simply.
Well, hey.
If your charcoal has been letting you down, get fast-starting Kingsford. Kingsford Charcoal, the surefire.
Attention all passengers and crew to Rigel 7. Please board shuttle 3800.
You gotta fight for your right to party!
Presenting the Heavy 80s. All your favorite 80s hits in one fantastic collection.
Don't hand me no lines and keep your hands to yourself.
Get the Heavy 80s for just $9.99 on compact disc or double length cassette. That's 18 awesome hits. Audition other great 80s albums. There's no minimum to buy. Cancel anytime.
Here I am. Rock you like a hurricane.
Call now.
To order Heavy 80s, call 1-800-483-3399 or send $9.99 for cassette or CD plus $3.50 shipping and handling to Heavy 80s, Department 8, Richmond, Virginia, 23280.
You know, I thought this was going to be a costume party.
Can I get a Manhattan?
Boy,
here?
This pad sure is crazy. And don't forget, it was Tony who found it and got permission to use it.
But is it really haunted?
Boo! Oh!
Donnie Least!
Stop scaring me!
Is this a haunted house? Do I have to call all the signals for you?
Well, you don't have to scare me to death. Sometimes I wonder why I date you.
Because you dig me and I dig you.
No, that's not
you know,
it.
Vic, sometimes I don't understand you at all.
The understatement of the year.
Hear this, hear this. Hmm? Vic's gonna sing this new crazy record for us right now.
Oh God, pant alert.
Elvis J. Pollard.
Tomorrow belongs to me.
I want a gal with a lot of dough. When I find her, we're gonna swing up to the preacher with the wedding ring. Tell me where she is, cause I don't know. So eeny, meeny, miny, mo.
London called and said I was there too.
Get away from me.
But so far she ain't been around. Someday I'll meet her and then I'll say, shoot, better be, baby, we're on our way.
Horrifying.
Hurry up now and follow me. But don't forget to bring your do-re-mi.
The dance team of Sissy and Sissy.
We're now entering a genital-free zone.
And suddenly it's a bad Dick Van Dyke show.
Oh, when clowns mate.
Whiskey a Go-Go really hadn't found its hipness yet.
And Gutterball.
May I cut in and kill one of you?
This is going over just as well as Letterman's Uma Oprah thing at the Oscars.
Ultimately, thank God for MTV, you know?
They would never allow this at the teen center.
Scooby-Doo. Sad or blue, you just call me baby and I'll run to you.
Why would I do that?
If you ever leave me, you're gonna pay.
Tempo.
$50 alimony every day. So I'll be yours from this.
Cab Calloway!
Well, no. Amateur night at the Apollo.
Rich girls sure are hard to find. But I'll keep a look until I lose my mind. She's bound to show up eventually. Then I'll be rolling in security.
And I'm just trying to cram in as many words as possible into the song.
So eeny, meeny, miny, mo.
Eeny, meeny, miny, mo. Eeny, meeny, miny, mo.
15 teenagers savagely tore apart one of their peers today.
Cindy Lou Bozo.
Let us call it rock and roll, and it will sweep the nation.
Well, I have some stock options that might interest you.
We got a nice present for Vic in that closet. You know he's always the life of the party, and he knocks himself out to entertain us? Yeah. Well, the kids got together to get him this present. Go on, you give it to him. You're his girl.
Oh, I'd be glad to.
She makes Sandy Duncan look like Betty Davis.
Oh, you whacked Tommy for him. That's great.
Some joke. Maybe you think it's funny, but I don't. Mm-hmm. And anyway, why does everybody pick on me?
You're right, baby.
How am I doing?
And from now on, anybody picks on you is going to have to fight me.
John Paul II.
Now for that, I'll collect a kiss in advance.
The Carnival of Souls, boyfriend.
Oh, Tony, I bet you had a lot to do with all this.
Me?
Yes, you.
Issue closed.
And I bet you're not so innocent either.
Now, why do they always pick on us?
It isn't fair.
I'll say it isn't. Just when I was going to give her a nice present.
That's women for you, no appreciation.
What present?
This one.
After all, I'm a respected orthopedic surgeon.
It's my gallstone, honey.
I don't know.
It's a new box.
Oh.
Candy! Opie!
Oh, my falsies!
I hate you.
Well, off to Vietnam, I guess.
Yeah, now she has years of post-traumatic stress disorder, arrhythmia, flashbacks.
Can you play the big drums like you do the bongos?
Just lead me to them. Can I play the big drums better than the bongos?
Great. They're in there.
Yeah.
And give me a real long blast, will you?
Sure, sure.
So no one has any accumulated memory or experience?
Ah, pig's blood, pig's blood.
It's the wet, deformed elf competition.
Thanks. I didn't even share it.
No, a wet him is worse than him.
All right. Okay, let's have some food, okay?
Yeah, Dad fits right in.
Come on, gang, let's eat. Yeah, at least there's no gags in the food.
This party's really percolating. I've never had so much fun.
A huge tin of generic tomato soup. Yummy!
And canned okra slices.
The exact moment Michael Landon became beloved by America.
This is all my fault.
Sock hop of the damned.
Eeny, meeny, miny, whoa!
I thought I was Dale.
I thought it was all right if I picked a little fight bonanza.
If only they'd provided milk to throw.
And Haas signs the commitment papers.
His office is a cabin up north.
Everything normal, my boy.
Now let's check you.
Physical examination is a formality, but a necessary one. Before we enter the mind, we must know the condition of the body.
Oh, you're nude already.
Tony, you're a perfectly normal human being.
Save for your tower of hair.
No reason in the world why you can't have a full, wonderful life. Mm-hmm. If...
Yeah, if. If I adjust, don't I?
It's the if we're going to work on, son. We'll work on it together. Okay, Tony?
You're the doctor. That's why I'm here.
Actually, I'm the receptionist, but I wind up doing most of the medicine around here.
All right, Dr. Wagner. Tony, will you just sit down over here?
Bissell, Landon, Werewolf, catch it.
Eric von Stroheim, nurse's aide.
I directed greed, now this.
What is it?
Just a mild sedative.
It's Thirsty Thursday here at the doctor's office.
It won't make me dopey or anything, will it? I have to drive home.
No, it's simply to relax you. Drink it down.
It's called Mega Wolf 2000.
Now that's a snappy tomato.
I'll be back in a minute.
I'll get your chips. I'm sorry, sir.
Wow.
Hugo, prepare the scopolamine.
Prepare the made-up thing.
Let's see if my underpants are cold yet.
Here's my bill. I'll just pay me right here.
What are you doing? Mm-hmm. I'm going to mix the serum with the scopolamine.
Over cracked ice.
But do you realize the possible consequences?
Realize one thing, that at last, after years of searching, I found a suitable person for my experiment. His record at school, what the school principal told me, and what I learned from Detective Sergeant Donovan gives him the proper, disturbed, emotional background I need.
I want
and
pudding.
What I found out from the physical examination, this boy is my perfect subject.
He has bonds of steel.
There were certain telltale marks on his body only I would recognize. But you know what might happen.
Right. In science, one must be sure.
Even movie science.
I'm going to take this out of the realm of possibilities. Into the world of exact science. If I'm successful, then I can be certain.
But you're sacrificing a human life. Do you cry over a guinea pig?
If it's Snowball...
This boy's a free police case. We're probably saving him from the gas chamber.
The boy's so young and the transformation horrible.
Another huge face.
You're a scientist. That's why you've never been more than an assistant. But if you interfere, if you say one word...
No, Alfred. You can trust me.
Rick.
Yes, I know that. You've been more than an assistant on other occasions. Accomplice would be a better word.
Here, try that. You'll kiss God.
What is the plan?
Through hypnosis, I'm going to regress this boy back. Back into the primitive past that lurks within him. I'm going to transform him and unleash the savage instincts that lie hidden within.
And then?
Isn't that enough?
Then I'll be judged a benefactor. Mankind is on the verge of destroying itself. The only hope for the human race is to hurl it back into its primitive dawn, to start all over again.
Or I could invent no iron sheets.
What's one life compared to such a triumph?
What did you do with Snowball?
Allure magazine asked its readers, what's the best shampoo and what's the best conditioner? Two questions, one answer. Pantene Pro V. Allure readers agree.
For hair so healthy, it shines.
These lights. They say it costs $1 million a day to light Las Vegas.
I've been here six times.
Twice. 46 times.
This is the best place to watch people.
Sigmund Siegfried.
Hey, aren't you guys Siegfried and Roy?
Roy.
Actually, I'm Siegfried. This is Roy.
can I get comps to the next show? Okay. That's
cool. This is a great place. There really is only one Las Vegas.
The new Firestone FT70C was recently tested against the Goodyear AquaTread 2. The Firestone tire has Unity technology, and at 50 miles per hour stopped an average of 12 feet shorter than AquaTread 2. Your results will vary, but that's a lot of feet. The difference is Unity, ultimate tire technology, in the new Firestone FT70C.
My family stopped brushing their teeth.
They did.
My mom says not to brush.
She does?
Today, smart families don't just brush their teeth, they reach with the remarkable Reach Plaque Sweeper. Its revolutionary bristle tip reaches where plaque and cavities start. No other toothbrush is designed like the Reach Plaque Sweeper. It lets you get even back teeth thoroughly clean.
You don't brush?
Nope.
To clean hard-to-reach places, don't just brush, reach.
Mia Hamm spends 90 minutes destroying her hair and 90 seconds bringing it back with the shampoo that conditions too, Pert Plus. Because Mia wants great hair with plenty of time for other things, don't you? Pert Plus. Simply great hair. Simply.
Every day I try my best to meet the challenges that come with doing the toughest job in the world. That job isn't being president. It's being a parent.
It's tougher than ever to be a good parent. It's a job that none of us can do alone.
That's why 350 wonderful organizations have come together to create the Coalition for America's Children to help parents raise good kids. The Coalition knows hundreds of ways you can help. We hope you will contact the Coalition soon. Thank you.
Now, as a teen, I assume you've shot up many times before.
Boss, can I get a bigger smock?
I only feel a scratch, believe me.
And then you'll feel incredible pain as the needle enters.
Spike is in my vein and things ain't quite the same. Bonanza.
Now go spot some trains.
This makes the hypnosis more comfortable and prepares the way for analysis. Now remember, I don't want to be disturbed.
Well, that was the needle. The damage is done. Why don't you schedule another appointment with the receptionist?
Tony?
Heal.
You must think of this as a trip.
To the vet.
A sort of voyage of discovery.
Man, I'm so
baked. On the way, we'll find out many fascinating things about you.
Fun factoids.
And in the end...
It's all crap.
You will no longer be disturbed or troubled, because you will be you.
And I am...
You've placed yourself in my hands. I'm the pilot, you're the passenger.
I am the words, you are the tune. Play me.
Instead of going forward into space, we're going...
to Davenport.
Backwards in time.
Is that all right, or...
Begin at 100 and count backwards. We'll start together.
Tony?
100.
100.
99.
Yes, Max.
99.
Yes, Max.
98.
98.
Oops, the camera was having an eye exam.
73.
72.
So they faded for 20 seconds.
72.
Quickly, tell me, where are you?
I'm in my treehouse and I'm nude.
I'm on a beach.
How old are you?
Pass. Next question.
About 12, I think.
Go on.
Go on, play.
I'm playing with some kids.
I'm leaving the legacy of love.
One of the older boys tries to take away one of our toys.
I throw milk at him.
He grabs it and runs away.
And what do you do?
I go tell Father Murphy.
I run after him.
Wetting my pants as I go.
I jump him. I scratch him, choke him.
He studied mumbling with David Duchovny.
He's older than I am, but he begins to cry.
So he's a total puss, then.
Some people gather around us.
Could you sum up Mr. Carlin's waiting for his appointment?
That'll be all for today.
Ooh. I'll get your check.
You may wake up.
I'm tired of being a psychiatrist.
Wake up!
Come on, come on, chop, chop. Gotta fill the chair. Turnover. Come on, come on.
You okay, Tony?
Wolf?
I'll see you...
in September.
Day after tomorrow at the same time. Don't worry, my boy. Soon you'll be yourself. Your true self.
An angel or a cowboy or a pioneer dad.
It's the back door of the Vertigo Church.
They have Angela Davis shrubbery.
Courtney loves prenatal care.
15.
Pi.
14.
Avogadro's number.
13.
Planck's constant.
13.
12.
And so on. I think you get the idea.
11.
11.
Where are you now, Tony?
I'm at Grandma's. She won't turn down the heat.
Where are you?
Very small.
Tell me what you're doing.
Playing with a box of men.
Filmed in sonovision.
2.
Divided by love.
2.
1.
Is the loneliest number that you'll ever do.
1.
Now where are you, Tony? Concentrate. Where are
he
you now?
He devolved too much. He suddenly enjoys Adam Sandler movies.
No, oh, man.
I don't know. I don't know it.
Well, I don't know, mister.
It's dark. Cold.
Where?
Wolf.
You tell me. Please tell me.
Where'd you put the remote?
I'll help you because I'm your friend.
Loosely defined, of course.
Will all become clear to you.
He's very bland, yet I hate him passionately.
Tell me.
No.
Tell me.
No.
Tell me.
Again, no.
How it felt to run over the hills in the moonlight, to hide by the stream, to wait in silence until...
No. No.
Remember how wonderful it was when you sprang suddenly, dug in with your fangs, a soft throat, the gush of warm blood?
No. No!
The lambs, Clarice. What about the lambs?
I want you to remember. You must remember.
Where's the outrage?
Yep, that crazy dig cat.
Arch Hall Jr. and Ada Annie, beatniks.
You know, Vic, you're good enough to sign up with a band.
He's had lots of offers.
Oh, get off my back, will you?
Is that what you told me?
Women who love arrhythmic trolls.
Tony, you can tell me to shut up if you want.
Shut up.
But you're not with it tonight.
Are you pregnant?
No, I'm not. Like, you're not yourself.
Usually you're a jerk.
Yes, I'm not myself.
I'm Coco Taylor.
I think I'll take Arlene home.
We'll stop in and visit her parents. They always cheer me up.
Come on, honey, let's cut out.
Well, I'm having fun, but okay.
That's right. I promised your folks I'd have you home by midnight. You listen home, Frank? And interfere with you lovebirds? No, thanks. Everybody else is paired up. How are you going to get home? How will I get home? I'll get home on my feet. I'll walk. I'll take that shortcut through the woods.
Ding, 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 ding,
right
victim!
Out by the power works.
Why don't you two join us at Ruby's drive-in?
No, we're going right home.
Go on, Tony. We'll lock up.
Oh, so you've joined the exclusive set.
The Amish.
No, you just talk too much, that's all. I'm for peace and quiet.
I follow Gandhi.
Come on, Tony, let's go.
I have to bleach my hair and face.
I'll just steal this purse and...
I'm fine. Walk, walk, walk. That's me all the time. Walk, walk.
And walking alone
night,
is
Ollie.
The best.
Good, morning,
good night, loser. I mean, Frank.
And that's why you like me, Arlene.
I'm sorry I made you yell at me, Tony.
Don't forget math. First thing in the morning, early.
Sure, I'll sack in right away.
So I bet you're real hot for that nondescript character we didn't give a ride home to, huh?
I'll probably get into the house fine. I'm sure there won't be any problems that you need to stay around for. Thanks, Tony.
So this guy sure can home us through the Carpathian Mountains.
I'm okay. I don't need a ride. What was I thinking? It's like 47 miles.
I'm probably pretty tasty and well-marbled. Not something I've often thought of.
Ray Fiennes is Lil Abner.
Is he whistling an Elliot Carter tune?
Oh, wait a minute. I was going to come out of my shell at that party tonight. Jeez, I forgot.
Least stealthy wolf in the world.
I was a teenage werewolf snack.
A textbook example of the weak one of the herd.
If only he didn't live on the other side of Glacier National Park.
Bet you anything, when he gets chased, his heel breaks and his skirt is too short to run in.
Yeah, yeah. Does a wolf have rice cakes in his shoe?
I hope it's not a girl.
Hello?
Hello. Teenage werewolf.
Yeah, there are so many playboys hidden out in the woods here.
Who's there?
Judge Crater.
D.B. Cooper.
Madeline Murray O'Hare.
You know, werewolves are just as afraid of you as you are of them.
That's true. Wow, his whistling's getting really good.
Prelude to the disemboweling of a teenager.
Well, it's the rare South American scarlet macaw again.
Whose woods these are? I think I know.
Who's there? Ooh.
Counselor, come out, wherever you are.
It's just someone returning a slide rule.
The medical definition of this is spaz attack.
Art Blakey and his jazz messengers are after me. Help me!
All the trees look the same. I can't remember which one I live in.
A werewolf like that, he kill your brother.
It's the kind of kid who would drown in a rainstorm.
Okay, I apologize for strange days, but I was really good in the English patient.
Oh, it's a horsefly. Get over it.
Please, not a wedgie!
Jeez, what a waste of sexual crime, huh?
If you wear ordinary contact lenses, your eyes may not be as comfortable as they could be. Irritating dirt and deposits build up.
How about the free contacts?
I was just getting there. But AccuView always gives you the comfort of fresh new lenses.
The free contacts?
Oh, right. Call Johnson & Johnson at 1-800-701-6100 and get a free trial pair of AccuView from your doctor. The contacts doctors prescribe most.
Free is good.
Your eyes will feel better all day long.
I like free.
You should call, too. 1-800-701-6100.
Dear Thompsons, my neighbors and I all built decks around the same time, but I used Thompson's Water Seal Waterproofer. My local store recommended it.
For unbeatable protection, America trusts Thompson's.
Over the years, they spent big bucks replacing damaged wood. My deck still looks new.
Our homeowners depend on Thompson's. Satisfaction guaranteed.
I guess you could say I'm one smart customer. Lenwood Cafe, Raleigh, North Carolina.
Also, try Thompson's wood finish colors for waterproofing with natural wood tones.
From Sony's PlayStation come the greatest hits, all your old favorites.
Like the soft sounds of swarming missiles.
And the gentle crack of Sophia's whip.
Even the hilarious antics of Sweet Tooth, that lovable clown.
All for just $24.99 each, but wait.
There's more? Oh.
That's right, the PlayStation is a mere $149. And you can also get leading titles.
Like Crash Bandicoot, Jet Moto.
For just $49.99 and less.
You are not ready.
Incredibly, Matchlight, the dependable one-match charcoal from Kingsford, is ready to cook on in just 15 minutes. So, the sooner you get Matchlight, the sooner you eat.
The Vidal Sassoon Academy with news you can use. If your hair does this, it's damaged.
Vidal Sassoon conditioners have protein and moisturizers that work to reduce split ends and breakage to help you have this Sassoon hair, perfect from beginning to end.
And in other news, police continue to search for kidnapped computer expert Clayton Rifkind. Mr. Rifkind is the best-selling author of How to Get Ahead in Business with Computers. Stay tuned for a detailed report after these messages.
Looking for a powerful business PC for just $23.99?
Call now to own this Dell Dimension XPS, powered by a 200 megahertz Intel Pentium processor with MMX technology. It comes with 32 megs of SD RAM, a 512K cache, and this Trinitron monitor.
A 4.3 gig hard drive.
Microsoft Office, a 12X CD-ROM, and a 4 meg Matrox Millennium video card. According to the top 5 PC publications, Dell Dimension is the most awarded PC line of 1996. No wonder 80% of the Fortune 500 are Dell customers. Call to order your Dell Dimension XPS, powered by a 200 megahertz Intel Pentium processor with MMX.
For just $23.99.
Thank you for calling Dell.
Any luck, Crow?
Yes, all of it bad. I can't detect beans, Mike.
Maybe you...
Arr! Arr! Arr?
Hey, Tom, what happened to the facehugger?
I hunted him down, ate him, and killed him.
Hey, where'd you get all the guns?
Well, 500 years in the lawless universe hardens a robot, my friend. Takes more than cigarette coupons to collect an arsenal like this, let me tell you.
Hey, nice pineapples. Ooh.
Those aren't pineapples, you wussy. They're grenades.
Well, that's what they call grenades.
They call grenades. How many people have you killed, huh?
I don't know.
Yeah, I swiped all this stuff off a dead Nortonian commando. That's where I got this deadly little neutron machine pistol. I call her Lucille, right, baby? Whoa!
Oh, he's coming!
Coming. Whoa. Back, Lucille. Oh, slow down. Geez. Steady down, girl. Sorry, it's all clear now. Don't worry, nothing. Whoa, look out!
Whoa,
look
at
that! There.
Finished, Rambo?
Yeah, I guess I'm all out of ammo. Well, I'm going in after the beast. She's taken to the ductwork. Don't try to stop me.
Okay, goodbye.
Oh, Mike, grab that radio off my belt so we can be in constant contact, okay?
Okay.
Here I go.
Hey, Tom, one more thing. How long before you come back crying?
Good
Mike,
one.
Jump up my butt, okay? I'm off. Silver wings. Jump up on
goodbye, jump. Brave Tom.
Aye, lad. So, Mike, I got a 20, says 30 seconds or less before he cries.
Okay, you're on.
Beauty.
Mother, this is Hawk.
Hawk. I'm sorry, Mr. Hawk. Who are you calling for?
Mike, it's me, Tom. It's really dark in here. Nobody told me about that, and they didn't bring a flashlight, and it's real dirty, and it smells like socks.
There we go.
Oh, no. Oh,
what's the matter, Tom?
Oh, no, I'm stuck.
Getting ready.
Don't cry out loud.
Ramping up.
You're okay, Tom.
You'll never walk alone. They're coming to America today.
Yes, that is a cry, my friend.
Ah, that's it. All right. There you go.
Good, Papa.
Enjoy. Yes. Oh, hey, we got movie sign.
Hey, what about me?
Just hang tight and don't let the alien eat you.
Wait a minute.
Poor
dope. Throw the bullet, Chris.
Thanks a lot, you knobs.
Oh, sorry. You okay?
Yeah. Right. Toma, Beretta, Petrocelli, Pepper, this time you've all gone too far.
These are official pictures?
Yes, Chief.
Does my bald spot show in this one?
I think you look better in hot pants, sir.
Strange.
They're upside down, sir.
Who found the body?
Art Logan, the auditor out at the power works. Takes that shortcut through the woods every morning. Says the only exercise he gets.
Yeah, we're really buff, so we can make fun.
Any idea how long the boy's been dead?
No, maybe the PM will show. The coroner has the body.
Boy, does he ever. Oh.
Strange. Slice on each side of his throat.
Well, I did that, sir. I just wanted to see if he'd catch it.
Got any ideas?
No.
But I've never had an idea ever, so.
Boy had no enemies. There weren't any gang fights in Rockdale.
Any bruises, scratches on his face, clothing ripped off?
No.
Then how was the boy killed? You got any theories?
It was the Big Bang, sir.
Not a shiv. Not hands.
Teeth?
No thanks, sir. Got some.
Fangs.
Fangs?
You're welcome.
no wild animals around here.
I've walked these woods since I was knee-high to a duck. I've never seen anything wilder than a tomcat.
I know. That's what makes it so hard to believe. But I still say fangs.
And I still say you're welcome.
Maybe if the boy had a chance to fight, his fingernails will show something.
Let's hope so.
In the meantime, let's keep the lid clamped down on this until the official reports come through. Maybe even after that.
And get Mark Furman on the case.
Whatever it is, we've got to be sure.
I told Art Logan not to say a word.
Good.
Kill him anyway.
Keep these locked now files.
Yes, Chief.
Bye, Meatface.
Just one rumor about fangs and the newspapers will have a field day. Not just the local papers, but reporters from all over the country will have on-the-spot coverage, photographers. They'll have a field day, all right.
Damn, First Amendment.
Here in Rockdale, we'll have a panic.
Yeah, I know. But I'm more worried about the teenagers at the school.
Now check the surrounding towns. See if a carnival, a circus, or a county fair has been setting up their tents.
I suspect a prono pup vendor.
Also, see if anybody has a private menagerie. Maybe a big cat got loose some way.
Yeah, drag Siegfried and Roy
in
here.
You had talked to the farmers in the surrounding areas.
They're nice folks.
Sometimes they keep a wild dog for protection. Whatever it is, we've got to be sure. Facts first. And don't encourage any rumors.
Shoot anybody talking.
Huh? Now, I've got to go and see the mayor.
Oh, and seal off the entire city under a giant plexiglass dome. Thanks.
Howdy, ma'am.
Hi, Pep.
Did anyone throw up in here?
I'm going down to the lab. Better get those pictures locked up in the file.
I hear there's a lot of throw up in the lab. You might want to watch out.
It's really Martin Landau in disguise.
Peppy!
Boy, Dennis the Menace's later years didn't go too well.
I left a copy of Swank in here. Did you...
I need changing again.
Oh, Chris, do you mind if I take a look at that picture?
You know the boy?
Once in a while, I played pinochle with his father. Very small stakes.
And french fried potatoes.
Yes, I knew the boy, but perhaps I have a better reason.
Tom Yule's last role.
Let me see the picture.
You're not to say anything about this to anyone, understand?
It's going on 12 years that I'm working here. Have I ever said a word?
Well, you messed up the Manson case for us. That was not good.
What's the matter? You see something we missed?
I forgot my glasses.
Poor boy. Poor boy.
Peppy, I don't blame you for being upset. Imagine how his family feels.
They all beefed.
I know what killed him.
You do?
Human being or catcher's mitt? You decide.
He was killed by a werewolf.
Oh, a Catholic werewolf.
A what?
A where?
In the old country. In my little village, in the Carpathian Mountains,
Europe,
there was
whatever.
A story passed on from generation to generation. Mm-hmm. Some say it was a legend, but I know it was the truth. I'll tell you what werewolf is. It's a human being possessed by a wolf.
You say that on every case.
When the evil eye is on you.
Forget about it.
The savage beast somehow gets inside and controls you.
Rush Limbaugh?
Makes you look and act like a wolf, makes you hunt down your victim and kill it like a wolf. Kill you with fangs like a wolf.
Kinda.
Why, you're crazy.
You're worse than Dr. Smith.
You better not let anyone hear you talk like that, Peppy. You'll wind up in a booby hatch.
Hey, fun.
Werewolf. Come on.
Yes, that's what I said the first time it was told to me.
I beefed.
Later, what I saw, what I heard, convinced me.
I'm going to put these away and lock the fire. You just forget I ever showed them to you.
And I'm calling the INS.
He's a janitor who doesn't play by the rules.
Yes. I'll be glad to forget this.
Go change some light bulbs.
Today's headline, Janitor Forgets.
Oh, that poor building code.
News for the Bland, page 3.
Well, hello, Tony, my boy. Come on in.
I'm kind of in already.
You're a little early, but welcome.
Get your drink?
Thanks, Dr. Brannon. Well, the reason I came early is...
You don't have to tell me why. Let me be the one to interpret the symptoms. After all, you have placed yourself in my hands, so to speak.
Patient input prohibited.
Tony, punctuality is a phase of adjustment. Sometimes the patient leans backward to be prompt, comes even before his appointment. Now, is that clear?
No, doctor, that's not why I'm here.
The bus was early, that's all.
I wanted to tell you about something.
No, you don't have to tell me now. I'll hear it all under hypnosis. I'll get the injection ready.
But, doctor, I found a letter jacket in my stool this morning.
Hippocratic oath, Schmippocratic oath.
Is the scopolamine ready?
Yes.
But the stuff in the minibar is really expensive.
Alfred, you read the paper. You know what happened.
There's a difference between a newspaper story and a scientific report. I have to be sure. Even in a minor experiment. You know how many guinea pigs are used up before the trailblazer is ready to announce a new discovery to the scientific world?
Three.
Surely you know how skeptical scientists are.
But I'm a barber.
They have to be.
But you realize the consequences.
I realize that I have an old woman for an assistant.
If you mean I have a heart, I don't consider that an insult.
You go, Grandma.
You're standing in the way of progress.
Progress? Do you call it progress to hurl back the human race to its savage beginnings?
Yeah.
It may prove to be the only road to progress.
I have a change purse, but that doesn't make me an old woman.
Hey, your liquid Pez is ready. The whole room has liver spots.
Go ahead, my boy.
Drop trowel.
Dr. Brandon, there's something I have to tell you.
And just chewed up your slippers.
I don't know if it really happened. It's more like a nightmare.
You've dated before.
Now, Tony.
Shut up.
Very often in psychotherapy, strange things seem to happen.
Because you're crazy.
Sometimes when we light up the dark corner of the human mind...
Doctor!
You're out of red books in the waiting room.
Doctor, please help me.
And do exactly as I say. All I can tell you is that your progress is excellent. I've even told the principal of your school that. Yes. I'm extremely pleased with the progress you've been making. And soon, Tony. Very soon.
We'll be married.
You'll be your true self again.
Boy, you'll be a werewolf soon.
Cool, he's got the Keith Richards signature syringe.
And after this, we'll go out for a nice naked lunch.
The rules say if you find the Graham Pastor M&Ms, the winning bag could be worth $1 million.
Show me the money.
Must have winning game piece on bag. Employees of M&M's, that's us, are not eligible. So, we'll quit.
The search is on for imposter M&M's.
Yep, it's still a Volvo. The new S70 from Volvo.
The most unexpected force in nature is about to strike L.A.
Will you tell me what's underneath the cars are parked?
She tried to warn them.
I hit the blast, it's gonna punch through.
You mean you're rough?
Yeah!
Now he'll try to save them.
You don't like my plan? That's good. Give me another plan, but don't tell me we're backing out.
And an entire city will unite. Impossible.
Dad!
Rated PG-13. The Coast is Toast Friday.
Mike Piazza spends 9 innings destroying his hair and 90 seconds bringing it back with the shampoo that conditions too, Pert Plus. Because Mike wants great hair with plenty of time for other things. Don't you? Pert Plus. Simply great hair. Simply.
Presenting Sounds of the 80s. Now, get all your favorite 80s hits in one dynamite collection.
She's a super freak, super freak, she's super freaky.
Get Sounds of the 80s for just $9.99 on compact disc or double-length cassette. That's more than one full hour of powerful hits.
There's something strange in your neighborhood. Who you gonna call?
Audition other great Sounds of the 80s albums. Cancel anytime. Sounds of the 80s is not sold in stores, so call now.
To order, call 1-800-714-0044 or send just $9.99 for one cassette or one CD plus $3.50 shipping to the address on your screen.
Now, this is a map of the area.
My area.
We'll start with the abandoned house.
Teenagers call it the haunted house.
Crazy Fresh kids.
Yeah, just informally. They had a party after a football game and went home. They all drove except Frank,
the loser,
who walked to the woods.
How about his parents?
His mother's in a state of shock. His father wants to know just one thing. What are the police doing about this?
Yeah, that's it.
Well, I wish I knew.
They'll all be down on us unless we find the killer.
Air Club for Men.
Chief Baker.
Stand by for an important message just for me? Neat.
Donovan. Yeah.
I'm just mad about Saffron, right?
Okay, thanks.
Mom says I can't eat over.
Picked up a couple of vagrants out of the freight yard.
Well, go ahead. I'll be right in.
I'm going to go pan-sear my face.
Well, I checked the neighboring towns. There aren't any circuses, carnivals, or county fairs. If they come at all, they come in the spring.
How about farms?
I checked those, too. They mostly truck, very little livestock, a few pigs penned up, some horses.
Werewolves.
There's a mink farm about 3 miles north of here. But they're all baby mink. First thing they do is cut off their teeth.
So he wasn't gummed to death by a pack of baby minks.
Everything seems to lead to a dead end.
Ann Miller in high school.
The world's most unflattering leotard.
Carrie Sloan.
Seriously, your form is improving.
Thank you, Miss Dolphin.
But I must repeat, we're judged on points, and Linwood High has won the gymnastic events 3 years in a row.
Oh, I certainly hope we win this time.
So do I. Yeah. Have you had enough for today? I've got to go.
Oh, gee, I'd like to practice for about another half hour.
Well, you don't need me. Just remember the other pointers I gave you.
Stop sucking.
I've got some shopping to do.
You go right ahead. Anyway, you make me very self-conscious, breathing down my neck all the time and picking on all my mistakes. I just want to try it a few more times.
That's the spirit. Good night.
Rosa Klebb, gym coach.
I can't believe Merlin Olsen got that flower gig.
Will you come in, Tony?
I'm just leaving.
Sure, Sister Mary Frank.
I hope you didn't mind waiting. I had some reports to finish.
This is clearly not the same set as the doctor's office.
You wanted to see me?
Yes, I wanted to have a little chat with you.
Well, it's required by the state.
And for heaven's sake, Tony, don't look so glum or so suspicious. For once, we meet on a friendlier basis.
No, you're not going to chew me out, then.
As you say, I'm not going to chew you out. Sit down, Tony.
Stay.
Thank you.
I have a report here from Dr. Brandon. Naturally, all this is kept strictly confidential.
Well, I tell my girlfriend.
It's a report of progress, which I'm happy to confirm.
You mean he says I'm adjusting?
Very much so.
Amen.
Your grades are about the same, but then your grades were always high.
And so were you.
However, your conduct is very much improved.
Except for the killings.
Tony, you're coming along just fine. Mm.
Thanks, I'm glad.
And as a reward, I want you to know that if you continue this way, you'll earn an honor certificate.
And a set of steak knives.
Yes, Tony?
An honor certificate.
I'll recommend you to the state college. Your grades will be high and your deportment will match.
Well, I did have a scholarship to Oxford, but...
This means so much to me, Miss Ferguson.
So far, every pupil I've recommended has reflected great credit on Rockdale High. And I know you will. So keep it up till graduation. Then you'll be off to your real career.
Chronic unemployment.
Thanks a lot.
You're a great old guy.
I always knew that if somehow we could just break through to you, I mean really get inside of you, you'd be a credit to your father and to your school.
And that you'd win best of breed.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Now I'll see you at home.
Dismissed.
You are Tom Jenkins, aren't you?
Could you and I ever be more than spinster and lycanthrope?
Wow, State College, then on to refrigeration school.
Ironically, State College has a no pets policy.
It's all right if I kill a couple kids' bonanza.
Hey.
Refreshman!
Get us out of here.
Does just walking through it make you want to kill yourself? Well, then it's a high school.
Wow, she's really, really bad.
I'm stuck. I'm stuck up here.
Ow! Ow! That was the gum of me. Ow!
Yeah, this is one sport that's come a long way since the 50s.
Yep. I am witnessing genius, the symmetry, the beauty, the definition of athlete. I gotta call John Tesh.
Ow! Ow! God, I'm doing it again! What the hell is wrong with me? The bells, 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 bells. The tintinnabulation of the bells.
The ear-level mounted bells.
Oops, he's Johnny Depping.
Ah, she does one move, but she does it well.
Let's see how Grecian formula works.
Hey, it's Lemmy from Motorhead, man.
That's it. I'm done for. My spine is broken.
What? What? Time for your compulsory being eaten routine.
I'm Bat, Werewolf Man.
Okay, I'm finished. You can use the bars.
I was a teenage dork wolf.
You know, he does look kind of like Bella Caroli.
Donna Shalala to the rescue.
I'm being attacked by a Berenstain bear.
tragic loss of this gymnast really debilitated the American Olympic team.
Judy Garland runs out of pills.
He's an English werewolf with teeth.
This is a job for old teen.
You know, he's just playing with his food now.
Looks like it's curtains for her.
Oh, God, he's wearing black sole shoes in the gym.
Mistakes were made.
This is good, though, because she caught him in the act and she can just shove his nose in it.
Yeah.
My hip.
My, I was a very rude teenage werewolf.
Billy Corrigan.
Should have got invisible fencing.
Jack in to the Dominion, the home of science fiction on the web. Welcome to the Edge.
Imagine a place that surrounds you with elegance and pampers you with luxury.
Williams, the car, please.
Introducing the Infiniti QX4. It has all the comfort and style you'd expect in an Infiniti.
Williams, while we're young.
It's just a bit more assertive. The new QX4.
Gotta get him up and out the door. Class full of kids he's getting up for. I'll start Folgers to brew. The aroma will pull him through.
Folgers, made from mountain-grown beans, with an A-plus aroma to start your morning right.
Gotta face each day brand new. Teacher's got so much to do. So the best part of waking up is Folgers in your cup.
From Sony's PlayStation come the greatest hits, all your old favorites.
Like the soft sounds of swarming missiles.
And the gentle crack of Sophia's whip.
Even the hilarious antics of Sweet Tooth, that lovable clown.
All for just $24.99 each, but wait.
There's more?
That's right. The PlayStation is a mere $149. And you can also get leading titles.
Like Crash Bandicoot and Jet Moto.
For just $49.99 and less.
You are not ready.
Kiss for Daddy. Bye.
Tiger Shark. One ride and you just might lose track of time.
Son? Dad! Whoa! Right on!
For a free video and the dealer nearest you, call 1-800-5T-SHARK.
Hey, Dad. Where have you been?
Did you see him?
Yes, I saw.
Did you recognize him?
I think it was Fido.
I'll call the police!
So, in answer to your question, yes, my face has been compared to a pork roast.
We thought we'd take the blankets out first, sir.
Wasn't a very good parade.
I'm having a generic emotion.
Miss Ferguson, I know this is difficult, but anything you can do to help us.
Could you help us move a couch?
He
ate his own vomit. Oh.
It came running out of the gymnasium.
It didn't have a hall pass.
I recognized it. Jacket. Trousers.
They were the same?
No, they were separates.
The same.
Ma'am?
Face.
That muzzle.
The eyes. The hands like claws.
Thanks anyway, ma'am, but you haven't been any help at all.
I never saw anything like it before.
But you recognized
it. It was Tony, all right. It was his jacket.
Anybody chase him?
No, it all happened too fast. Besides, we were paralyzed, man. Just too paralyzed. Man.
And then he disappeared.
Yeah, like an animal. They jumped the fence and ran to the fields.
Man. Ha! Good God, y'all!
This all could have been prevented with a few firm leash laws.
He just glued crepe hair to his football helmet.
I'm sorry, Sergeant, but I cannot be swayed by mass hysteria.
But there were eyewitnesses who swear they saw him.
Hallucinations.
That's what I need.
I'd have to see this so-called beast with my own eyes. After all, a scientist needs a platform of concrete facts before venturing an opinion. and overwhelming proof before stating a conclusion.
Slabo face.
Doctor, this is hardly the time for a lecture. You had Tony under your professional care. You were with him time and again. Mm-hmm. You were supposed to help him.
As far as I know, I did. His behavior after I took the case proves that.
Mm-hmm. Did you come across any hint, a clue? Mm-hmm. Did he reveal anything?
I keep careful case histories of all my patients, but I don't need to tell you that's a matter of strict confidence between doctor and patient.
Yes, I'm aware of that. However, we hoped you would cooperate. Help us.
Don't you think you're wasting a lot of valuable time interrogating me? After all, your duty is to try and find this,
Hat? Spoon?
This young man.
Now he unleashes the full force of his face at him.
Why do you shy away from the word? Everyone's using it.
Groovy.
Werewolf.
I do not subscribe to old wives' tales. It's my belief that these legends or myths passed out with the invention of electricity. After all, this is America, modern America, not a hamlet in the Carpathian Mountains.
What did the Carpathian Mountains have to do with us?
Good skiing.
That's where the legend was born. The people there believe in werewolves.
Yeah, they also believe in hairy armpits for women.
The shadows of night creep over their gloomy hills. The hungry dogs howl in the moonlight.
Stop it!
The peasants cross themselves and hide in their huts. Any canine they see with sharp white teeth and glittering eyes, they call a werewolf.
Even a fish!
Doctor, you seem to know a great deal about these myths.
I amuse myself with fantasy.
Like I'm the stable boy and my assistant is the Contessa.
I live by facts.
I'm Whit Bissell. Good night.
Hi, Peppy. You're in late tonight.
Oh, a whole lot of throw up today.
Oh, Chris, would this teenage girl kill the same way?
Peppy, yeah. I got your new same toilet way. Brush.
I told you. I knew. A werewolf.
Tell me something, Peppy.
Have you tried Tylex?
In the old country, did they ever catch a werewolf?
Never. Never.
Never. Oh, you know, wait a minute. They did most of the time, now that I think of it.
So he has the whole woods and he can't find a decent tree.
No, they couldn't shoot at night because the night belongs to Michelob.
I thought the night belonged to lovers.
Yeah, it did, but it was bought up by Michelob.
Oh. Yeah.
Did your boyfriend ever give you any indications?
Never, never.
Colonel Mustard did it.
Do you realize that if this thing had come over him when he was with you...
Now, there's no use upsetting our little girl any more than she is now. Sorry that you talked to her in the first place.
Yes, I think that's enough. She's been crying ever since this thing happened. She must get more rest.
Ooh, sorry
well,
about that.
Well, just one more picture.
Exclusive photo of the mother and father of the girlfriend of the alleged werewolf.
Now, you're not going to let her go to school.
Well, school's closed till this thing is over. Anyway, we'll protect her right here in our own home.
Right here in our very own home?
You don't really believe that your son is we...
No, I can't believe.
What kind of a boy was Tony?
Real lively, like me.
Is Tony. He was always on the quiet side. Kept pretty much to himself.
Collected roadkill, kept a kettle of hands.
Maybe I should have remarried. A good woman around the house, the affection of a mother. Mm-hmm. A boy needs that. Especially when he's grown up.
What I'm saying is, will you marry me?
Not that Tony ever complained. I even asked him. Does he miss... Should I? He said, no, Dad.
That's not my piddle.
We'll get along all right. Just two of us.
And what the hell did I ask you again?
No woman could ever replace his mother in my heart.
Racco.
Or in his... What I mean is, did he always obey you? Yes. Only I didn't know how to ask him. Ask him the right way and he'd do anything.
Just give him a liver snap.
Tony's a good boy.
Oh, he's a milk tosser.
I don't care what they say. Tony's a good boy. Mm-hmm. Yet he hasn't come home or you haven't heard from him since he left his school early this morning. Mm. Oh, certainly he must know how worried you are.
J. Edgar Hoover, grief counselor.
Of course, you know what the principal and his teenage friends are saying about the terror. Hmm. How it looked. Wouldn't this indicate to you that perhaps Tony's... Leave me alone, will you?
Baby, you gonna cry now, baby?
Leave me alone.
Yeah!
Dude, hey,
eggs? The confounded alien hell beast is laying her eggs? Or did we always have these?
No, we didn't always have giant alien. Okay, I've got a plan. We'll make a giant omelet, and we'll eat it before she sees us. Yes. It's our only chance.
Yes, yeah. Brilliant. I'll make sure she's not watching.
And I'll work on the menu.
Okay, that's a good idea. Get pictures of the food and...
Uh-huh.
Would you just hurry
up? This is going to be so cute. I've always wanted a little breakfast place.
Bad news, Mike. She's not around, which means she couldn't be anywhere. That means we have to eat fast!
Fast! Okay, here's a little bit done for you. All right, Crow, we need you to get in here and eat an omelet.
Gotta eat fast!
Fast.
Well, hello. Do you have a table? How about right here? Thank you. Ah, let's see. What do you have? The 20-egg cock-a-doodle omelet, the 40-egg omelet of Mattis Egg County, and the 60-egg egg-a-palooza. Is the cock-a-doodle omelet enough for me, you think?
Quit screwing around. Eat that.
Well, I just may, although I see some wonderful waffles on here. Hey, Tom, what are you having today? Oh, that sounds great. Waiter! Waiter, are you my waiter? Could you come back in just a tiny minute? I'm not quite ready. Oh, look, the story of the Eggapalooza. Grandma Smirker, loved
by one
and all...
Quit screwing around and eat that omelet!
That is a rather surly attitude, Mike. What if I were a restaurant critic? In fact, I am a restaurant critic. You didn't know that, did you, pal?
Okay, here you go. Oh, whoa, whoa.
This is going to look really good in my column.
Well, just eat that fast. We'll be right back. Eat!
Inattentive service and brutal assault with steaming eggs marked my visit last week to what was formerly one of my favorite breakfast places.
Nothing takes you out of the action faster than a diarrhea medicine that can let you down. But you can count on Imodium AD to stop diarrhea often in one dose. You could end up taking dose after dose after dose of the pink stuff to stop diarrhea as effectively as Imodium AD. Don't take chances when you have diarrhea. Take Imodium AD, one dose relief you can count on. The problem with ordinary fertilizers is they only work their best when the weather's perfect. And the problem with that is the weather usually isn't. But Vigoro fertilizer from the Home Depot nourishes your lawn in all kinds of conditions, which gives you a lush green lawn whether it's hot, cold, wet, or dry outside. So now, no matter what Mother Nature dishes out, it's still a beautiful day for Vigoro. Only at the Home Depot.
You know it makes me wanna shout, 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 shout.
New Shout Wipes. Now wipe out stains wherever you go. Just rub on to help remove stains in a matter of seconds. Shout Wipes. Keep them on you to keep stains off you. SC Johnson Wax.
Riverdance. It swept Europe and now is sweeping the U.S. Experience this symphony of sight and sound, now available on home video. Feel the pulsating rhythm as 80 performers ignite your passions. Order Riverdance today and you'll save $5 through this special TV offer. Now you can own your copy of Riverdance for only $19.98. Don't miss your chance for the original Riverdance. Order now.
Have your credit card ready and call 1-800-538-9339 to order Riverdance. Order today and save $5. Only $19.98 plus shipping and handling. That's 1-800-538-9339. Sorry, no CODs.
It's good stuff.
Hey, the wolf went out for cross country.
So his paws just fit in his shoes, huh? Mm-hmm.
John Malkovich takes a nap.
Pat, men are all ready.
Thanks.
I'm just kind of depressed, but I guess I'll go. It's my job.
Hey, now.
It may seem like a long shot, Donovan, but if we can capture it before morning, save the community a lot of trouble. Mm-hmm. And panic.
You can try, but night in the woods is going to be tough.
One thing in our favor, can't go very far, can only travel on foot. Also, it's got to stop to rest and eat.
Well, how about we put a pork chop on a string and lure him under a box and slam it down on him?
Ed, this is Jed, Ned, Cletus, Scooter, Cooter, Jim Bob, Joe Bob, Clem, Clay, and Bocephus.
All right, now, we'll move in stagger fashion.
Because we're drunk.
We'll circle the outer edges first, and keep going round and round till we meet in the center.
So take your Dramamine.
If you run across it, or even if you see any suspicious tracks, notify me immediately on the walkie-talkie.
Or scream hysterically.
I don't fire unless you're attacked. I want to try to bring this thing in alive, if possible. Oh, another thing. When we get further in the woods, I want you to light the torches. Animals are afraid of fire. Maybe werewolves are, too. All right, let's go. Come on, Don.
Animals are also afraid of vacuum cleaners, sir. Should we bring a bunch of those?
Yep. Hey, Mr. Douglas, you searching for werewolves?
Here, boy.
Try banging on his food dish, men.
Yeah, so, werewolf.
That's exactly what we're trying to find out.
Good one.
Remember that time we burned that cross over there? What a time.
You know, the Bernard Herrmann score really heightens the tension, doesn't it?
Oh, man.
Jeez, I told you to fan out.
We're scared.
All right, men, close up. We're going to light the torches.
Sir, I got to get back and transfer Oswald.
Now, Ed, Charlie, take a couple of torches and go on up the hill there. Donovan, will you take a man and beat up this ravine?
But, sir, the ravine didn't do anything.
I love that.
Fudd, you check the woods and be very, very quiet.
All right, you go ahead.
We will march into the Forbidden Zone.
Well, sir, I stepped in some werewolf dew.
Take back the night, men.
Man, if you see him howling around your kitchen door, you better not let him in.
Rary interest ring, but rupid.
A super stealthy Denver pile.
White trash, black heart.
He looks like Paddington on a bender.
And the werewolf is a herbivore. Luckily, this guy's name is Herb.
Thank you.
Oh, rumpa-pum-pum. Rumpa-pum-pum.
Hi.
Rumpa-pum-pum.
The murder of Joe Besser.
Hey, Mike, come over here.
Me? Did he mean... Was he...
I don't know.
Movie, Mike.
No.
Take a look at this stump that looks like Nixon.
For sale by Hobbit, contact Samwise Gamgee.
Sorry, Mr. Sasquatch.
Personally, Jeb, I prefer the London production of Starlight Express.
We'll find the bodies from Stand By Me, River's Edge, Twin Peaks.
Wow, is that me?
Yee.
I'm Alpha.
No, wait, let's sniff butts and talk about this.
Well, he shouldn't have worn his beef bullion after bath splash.
Give me back my pig's ear, you jerk.
You vowed your love from here to eternity.
Say, Cletus, how much pork gravy do you use to make toast?
Ed Norquist and Stan Torkelson, they're cops.
He's actually an I was in Argentina during the war, Shepard.
Don't mention the war to this dog.
God.
Look, let's call it a draw. I got some guys after me.
You know, Bull Connor shouldn't let his dogs just run around. And...
Honey, is that you?
He finally just kneed him in the groin and snicker snagged on him.
Ted Danson!
Hey, Vern, looks like they killed the dog, huh?
One member of the incredible journey down.
Man, we're a terrible posse.
Lenny and Squiggy, knights.
Eh, nothing but half-eaten dog up here.
Indiana Jones and his sidekick, Merle.
Hi, did you fail, too?
Yeah, we searched Hooters, Deja Vu, Buns and Roses, and Fatburger. No luck.
All right, hold it. Oh, Donovan, did you see anything?
There's a dog back up there he killed.
Well, I suppose they do those things.
And he's got to be in here someplace. No sense looking for him in this light, though. Look, Donovan, post guard so he can't possibly escape. Mm-hmm. We've got to get him.
Ollie, Ollie, oxen free.
Hello.
Never let Jose Feliciano lead your search party.
Ah, time for a good round of scooting.
The manhunt was organized by the Lilydale Senior Center.
Sir, I think I saw a werewolf with a Chinese menu in his hand.
1943, an Ewok makes it behind German lines.
Corn sarn it.
Dadgummit.
Son of a biscuit. Dag nabbit.
H-E double toothpicks.
Great Caesar's ghost.
And the scene just peters out then. Yeah.
Meanwhile, at Dad Noir's house.
Go ahead, answer it. Just tell him to give himself up. Tell him it's the best way. Advise him as his father to surrender.
Well, do you think Sprint needs to know all that, sir?
Did he lose his butt cheeks in World War II?
Hello?
Yes, he's here and he won't leave.
Thanks. Thanks.
Dr. Kevorkian will see me on Tuesday.
It's only the foreman. I'm not being docked for staying home tonight.
I'm being fired.
If that matters.
To celebrate, I might sit in a different chair tonight.
As if anything could matter.
Another slice of stale Wonder Bread for you?
I knew for sure he's still alive.
Hey, I'm not finished with the scene yet.
Wow, what a beautiful gray spring day.
Oh, I may have overscooted.
Oh, I overslept. I got a full day of marking territory.
A sandwich is a sandwich, but a man is a meal.
So he's lettered in nothing, I guess.
Well, that's right. I was supposed to live long and prosper.
I think Nellie Olson is behind all of this.
They're about to close the lunch buffet at Nilda's.
Look what I found. Like a cloth ripped off. How do you know it's his?
Oh, hi, Tony.
What would you think if I wore tiny shorts with this smock?
Alfred, don't interrupt Hugo.
These junior jumbles are very difficult.
Alfred, aren't you wasting your time? Or do you have a second victim in view? I'm not wasting my time, and I don't like to hear the subject of a world-shaking experiment referred to as a victim. Call him what you like, but he's being hunted down like a dangerous animal.
Well, that's his deal.
And after he's captured. Mm-hmm. I'm so sure he will be captured. Mm. Transformation into a werewolf is not all on the minor side. It also gives the subject the cunning of an animal.
Well, then I want Friday off.
And you think somehow he will come here?
I have his Gainsburgers.
All I have to do is wait. He must come here.
I'm with Bissell.
They created electronic trading, and a global intranet became their trading floor. An intranet now able to handle a billion shares a day, with trades flashed to 300,000 monitors around the world in milliseconds. With reliability critical, with no room for error, who did NASDAQ turn to build and manage the world's largest intranet? MCI. Imagine now what we can do for you.
This little celebration is brought to you by the people who've helped so many other people understand and enjoy cellular phones. Radio Shack, America's number one retailer of cellular phones. Surprised? We're not. We're just happy. Radio Shack, you've got questions, we've got answers.
Imagine, this is Florida, and that's Walt Disney World, SeaWorld, Universal Studios, Epcot Center, And this is Kissimmee St. Cloud, offering the closest and most affordable accommodations in the middle of Central Florida's best attractions. Call 1-800-403-KISS, and we'll send you a free vacation guide with information on affordable hotels and campgrounds. If you can stay here, why stay anywhere else? Kissimmee St. Cloud. Location is our biggest attraction.
Cool stuff for gifts. The Sci-Fi Traders. Cool stuff from the cosmos. Sci-Fi Channel next.
In his one-man war on crime, Dr. Miles Hawkins has perfected the ultimate biological weapon. Madness.
He created something that gives me power.
From the creators of Batman and Darkman comes Madness. Sunday at 8 p.m.
Do I smell bacon? Why, yes, I do.
Everybody's barking at me. I can't hear a command they're saying.
Hey, you!
Want to see me wail on this old lady?
Next time, use the crosswalk.
You think that'd be all right?
Kids with their walking.
One or more people aren't killed.
Time to turn into Super Werewolf!
Yeah, it's gonna call the pound and casually ask what they do with the strays.
The brutal interrogation of Cindy Brady.
So they still wore powdered wigs in the 50s, huh?
Let her answer.
He's got a good phone voice.
All right, miss. You answer it.
Answer nice and slow and nobody gets hurt.
Remember now, hold them long enough so we can place the call.
The calls are coming from inside the cop.
Werewolf's girlfriend, how may I direct your call?
Make him talk, you little werewolf-loving tart!
I just got my hat blocked.
You want to score some crack, son?
God. I don't like him.
Dad, Pablo Neruda waits nearby.
Whoever he was, he hung up.
You're going down, Cupcake.
Do you recognize his voice?
I couldn't be sure.
I got some feelers on the street. I'll check in with Huggy Bear.
Look, miss, if you're trying to protect him by holding back anything, you're wrong. His best bet is to give himself up.
Well, I only heard the word hello. How could I be sure?
If you'd stop hooking for 30 seconds, you'd know what kind of trouble you're in.
Ooh. Find comfort in my jowls, honey.
Later on NYPD Gray.
Sergeant Donovan.
Big face here.
Where? 10th and Hudson. Thank you. 10th and Hudson. What happened? Somebody just caught sight of him. Downtown? Makes sense. No trace of him in the woods and all the roads are blocked. Let's go, Chris.
Sergeant Chris.
Oh, good. Whit Bissell will light a fire under this film.
The results of the case of Mrs. Banks indicate that...
I've made her into a were-chicken.
I was expecting you.
You are Meadowlark Lemon, aren't you?
Come on in, Tony.
Remain in, since you are already in.
Dr. Brandon, I know what I am.
I'm a dancer, damn it.
What I become...
It was on my vaccination tags.
Help me, doctor, please!
Wow, honey.
I know they're going to kiss me, but don't let anyone see me like that. Please, doctor, help me!
Got a thorn in my paw!
Please, help me!
Of course, Tony, of course.
Who's your main provider?
Come on over here.
Get in your pet taxi.
Look, don't start.
Alfred, I beg you. It's too late to bring the dead back to life. But at least you can help him. Mm-hmm. Help correct a terrible mistake. Mistake? You dare call a scientific triumph a mistake? Mm-hmm. What are you going to do now?
Aromatherapy.
You must make the voyage back once more. I must see with my own eyes and record with my own camera. Here. You'll be the witness. We'll have it all on film. From the time I first give him the injection through the transformation. And then no one will doubt my word. Even... the most exacting, the most skeptical of scientists will be convinced that I have penetrated the deepest
secrets of creation.
Like, how do they make frogs?
And I've achieved...
things.
The first perfect case of regression.
I trust you implicitly, Doctor. Nothing bad has happened under your care.
Oh, thank goodness all the aircraft employees were sane this month.
Okay, show me some fur, sweetheart. Ooh, let's see those pearly white canines.
Okay, you want your hockey equipment for the next picture?
You know, he's Pete Sampras.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Excedrin headache number 12.
Tova Borgnine, you've done it again.
Joe Esterhaz.
God,
Doc.
Don't! I'm not here.
Oh, jeez. I forgot I had clothes on and I'm piddling.
If that's Rin Tin Tin, tell him I've just left.
Don't do anything. Dogs can sense bad acting.
Help her, stop him!
You know, if they had him neutered, he'd be more docile.
Cut it out! I'll harm you, I'll give you such a pinch! Ow!
Lunchables, anyone?
Why did I keep the number of the pound in the safe?
Now, this is gonna be really sad, like the end of Old Yeller, isn't it?
sit?
Ew!
Tony, I'm your friend.
I let you kill my assistant, didn't I?
I'm the only friend you've got.
Look, we'll negotiate your copay.
Tony,
you can dance. You can get out of here.
Well, that didn't look right there.
Tony!
Ranchers often complain that werewolves come in and trash Tony. Their houses.
So, Tony, you want to reschedule for next week?
Oh, a werewolf that size can really poop.
Grandma?
Oh, why don't you just finish the doctor and then we'll talk about it.
Halt or I'll shoot.
Apparently he was wearing a lot of talc.
Good thing we switched to standard issue silver bullets a few years back.
Maybe they just should have waited for the sanctions to work.
There's no other way out.
Right.
Nothing else we could do.
Right.
We had to.
Rationalize.
Yeah. Did you see his face? I mean, before? I'll never forget it.
Until the hearing.
But at least they'll see him this way now.
Riddled with our panicky bullets.
What about him?
You want to shoot him?
I don't know. My hunch is the score was even. Boy, the newspapers will just eat this up.
Or they might just reprint, please God, I'm only 17.
Yeah. But after they've had their field day,
it's big.
One thing will be clear. It's not for man to interfere in the ways of God.
No? Remember, only get injections and past life regressions by licensed mad psychiatrists.
Before your credits, caress.
And Arlene's parents buy her a puppy to comfort her.
You know, I don't mean to be picky, but their ellipses are unevenly spaced.
Chief Baker? You mean they got fresh baked goods on this shoot?
What's going on here? We're losing power.
Red alert! Something's draining all energy from the ship!
Oh, you see, it's the alien.
Ah! We're gonna die!
It's literally feeding on us, Mike. We need to repulse it.
You mean sour its milk?
Ugh. What if we reversed the ship's polarity?
Yes.
That's it.
Reverse the ship's polarity.
Reverse the ship's polarity.
Yes. And polarities reverse.
Bad news, Mike. The alien loved that.
I'm gonna die, and I never even really live.
We need something that will really repulse it.
For example, I never got to snowboard or eat steak tartare.
Mike, do you think at long last that it may finally be time to...
Servo, no! We always said Mike would only do that if we...
If we faced imminent death, which we do, my friend. And we may die, yes, but if we meet on the other side...
Hurry, Mike, it's growing exponentially.
He's doing it. Mike's become the most repulsive thing in the known universe.
Adam Duritz of County Crows!
Oh, yeah. Someone's getting close to understanding Elvis.
Oh, God, no, let the alien kill us instead!
Elvis, you're
must
funky
be
as
strong.
You can be around here. Everybody wants to understand Mr. Jones.
It's working, Mike!
Around here. Around here.
Oh, it was horrible.
Shush, honey. It's gone now.
No, it's still right there with those hideous hair extensions.
Mike, Pearl and her crew are calling us.
Mrs. Forrester, how could you leave us like that?
Yeah. An alien came aboard our ship and laid a bunch of eggs, and I had a facehugger on him, and it tried to suck the life out of us, and
we just got really scared.
Oh, did a widow, baby. Get him all skitty-witty. Oh.
They were scared.
Scared. Really, Nelson, I am embarrassed for you.
You think that was scary? I'll show you scary, you toddlers. Gather around, everybody. It's time.
Oh, it's scary story time.
Interesting.
Warning, you may get the crud scared out of you.
Crud, all right.
Once upon a time...
Sorry.
Once upon a time, there was a little gorilla. This little gorilla was very, very naughty.
No.
So one scary day, something very scary happened to this little gorilla.
No. Oh, how absurd to be so easily frightened. It evidences scant knowledge of the true workings of the universe.
I agree, which is why I know you'll enjoy this next story.
Oh, I'm quite certain that I will. Please proceed.
Once upon a time, there was a little boy in a robe and a hood. A little boy who carried his own brain around in a little brain boy.
I think I know where you're going with this.
This little brain boy never did what he was told.
Oh, really?
One day the little brain boy went away and never came back.
No, the universe wouldn't be so cruel. No.
And do you know why he never came back?
Why?
Because he died!
Oh, that's horrible.
Fish in a barrel.
Oh, that's terrible.
One day they mashed up his brain into hummus, and the little gorilla ate it, and it was poison, and he died.
Bug me too.
Produced in association with the Sci-Fi Channel.
This worldwide weird report is brought to you by AXA Insurance.
Real news, downlinked from our master satellite. This is Worldwide Weird.
Doctors in India were astounded when a man came stumbling into a hospital with a strange scar and an even stranger story. It seems the man had checked into a local motel for the night and awoke the next morning feeling strangely groggy and in intense pain. When he examined himself, he noticed that a huge incision had been made on his body and then stitched up. He panicked and hurried to the hospital. Doctors confirmed he had been secretly operated on and a kidney was stolen out of his body. Many had heard the rumors and legends of the secret organ harvesters, but until now, no one at the hospital had ever seen such confirming evidence. The man is stable and free of infection. Doctors determined that whoever performed the operation was well trained and had a good knowledge of surgical procedures. Authorities are still clueless as to who stole the man's kidney.
This is Worldwide Weird.